but also for the family. So I thank you so much for this mentorship so far.
Wow, thank you very much. That's a very good testimony that we do not only talk in the morning. Some things are happening, you know, people are visible, and we say that visibility brings credibility, and credibility brings profitability. So very soon, we'll see your tithe go up because money will be coming fast and furious. So thank you for that testimony. Great. Let's hear one more person, two more people.
I have something to say.
Okay, go ahead.
Good morning.
Morning.
As for me, after rebranding myself online, I've gotten a group of students from Kenya Wildlife Service who want me to mentor them on personal branding, and they are doing a paid mentorship. So at least I'm going to get money as I mentor other young people. And the other thing is, they are registering a safe space for women in agri enterprises that I will teach them on making their businesses bankable. Yeah.
Okay.
That's all.
Good.
So thank you very much. That's very good, very encouraging. Rebranding, the power of rebranding. This is very, very encouraging, the power of rebranding. You know, I'm very excited when I hear testimonies that things are happening. And this is very encouraging. I can see, Wakalo, you also have something to say. Go ahead.
Yeah. Good morning, mentees. Right. It's all about networking, and I'm grateful for this. You know, the entire thing that we are doing through Bana George Okiuru. And one thing I just wanted to say is, I'm happy that I'm connected through, there's a lady from German called Nuru. I think when I knew through knows her, she got back to me.
I know her.
Yeah, she got back to me, and we are trying to network in terms of the German clients, you know, coming to Kenya, because I'm a tour operator. So I believe that is also a milestone. Through this forum, which is really, and we are learning a lot in terms of networking and, you know, time consciousness and, you know, and also valuing our clients, because I believe each and every session that we are learning, it gives us a leeway to be able to progress and also to capture some of the things that we've gone through. So to me, it's impacting me very well, and at least I've learned a lot, and I believe I'm looking forward for the graduation, Bwana George Okiuru. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Livingstone. Very good testimony. Wow. I think now, even if we add this as cohort two, there are a lot of benefits. I'm so happy to hear those testimonies, people networking, people doing stuff, because they say that iron sharpens iron. And that was the purpose of this mentorship. And I'm so, so happy. I have also seen Miri Thu go to the next level, you know, just going ahead and writing a book, you know, authoring a book, which is very, very encouraging. And I have also seen her on platforms. She's very aggressive in terms of marketing, looking for business, because that is the way to go. That's how to behave like Asians. You know, that's what Asians do. They assemble together, they exchange ideas, they implement, they ask for support. And the one thing I would encourage this team, please don't break the team. Ensure that you keep the network, you know, you keep talking. And if there's a business that you can exchange, please exchange business. So if you're looking for services and any of the mentees have got those services, please, let's promote each other. That's something that I would like to encourage you, because that's how we grow. That's how you see other communities, like Asian communities. That's how they grow. They exchange businesses in the temple, you know? So let's be one family. Amen. And let's keep the move. Wow. Okay, without much ado, I think we'll go to the next level, unless it's somebody who is burning with a testimony. So maybe one more person who is burning with a testimony. Welcome, Nagilai. Anybody else who want to share experiences?
George, I know one of your mentees called Eva Angoi, and he must be on board. She can talk, because I know she has a brilliant idea. She can share.
Okay, Eva, go ahead.
Good morning, everybody. I am really blessed and glad to be a part of George Washiori's mentorship group. I've been working a lot with Mr. George Nyoto, Joseph Nyoto, to, you know, with an idea that I had in mind to start a daycare, an academy in Konza City. So George and I, Joseph and I have actually built, you know, done a business plan and things are rolling. We're looking into, you know, keeping on with the vision, with the dream for, you know, not only myself, and but for my children, my children's children. And it, I don't think that I would have gotten where I am with this, you know, business proposal and business plan had I not joined the mentorship group. So for that, I'm really thankful.
Wow, very encouraging, Eva. That's a fantastic testimony that a partnership, which is our discussion today, is already working in this particular mentorship group. That's very, very encouraging. And thank you, Eva. Keep the push and all the others. So please prepare your testimony because you shall be able to deliver it at a GMC place. I'll ask, I can see Marion Joyce also have got a testimony. Very, very encouraging. This is just amazing. This is just amazing. So Marion, go ahead. Marion Joyce, go ahead.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Marion.
I am a former student to Joseph Nyoto at KIM. He was my professor, and I'm very encouraged this morning.
Wow, wow.
My testimony is that I have an insurance agency. My background is insurance. And because of this networking and rebranding, two weeks ago, I signed a contract with AMREF Flying Doctors. I'm now selling rescue and evacuation. And so I'm so excited to be given a chance, even during the graduation, to network and to really educate people on how important it is to even purchase ambulance services, because as you know that most people get stuck to get to hospital because of lack of ambulance services, and it's very, very cheap. So I am very excited, and I know by the time we are doing the graduation, I'll be set to come and network with your group, Mr. George Washiori, and I'm so blessed. Number two, I have been following up on your YouTube. I have a group of people who work for my agency. I have some people I'm mentoring. And let me tell you, your YouTube have really empowered me. You can imagine me telling them, like educating them on friendship, on money matters. You know, like I talk like I'm talking like George Washiori, and I'm so excited to be here. God bless you.
Wow, I think it's so sweet to hear testimonies. thank you, Marion, and you will keep growing. I can't wait to meet you during the graduation, and extremely encouraging. And Professor, thank you. You see, your students are here, Nyoto, the people you taught at the KIM, so it's very encouraging. Okay, interesting. Do I see another hand there? Let me see who is this raising the hand. I can see Simiu says that, yes, I'm writing my story. So thank you, Simiu. We shall be able to share your story once you write it and just post it on the group. We shall be able to read it. And Simiu has got very, very interesting story that challenges cannot deter you from moving to the next level. Regardless of cerebral palsy, Simiu is soldiering on with registering his own company, and the guy is moving. So thank you very much. Wow, that's good. So without much ado, maybe I'll give Donald, who is hosting us at the GMC, whether everything is ready. Donald.
Good morning, good people. It's yet another wonderful morning that we meet here to be mentored by our mentor, Bwana George. Thank you so much. At GMC, we are excited. We are so much excited and ready to host the entire team. We are in touch with Nagilai. We are coordinating the logistics. He will be communicating further details about the same. But from our end, we are prepared. a lot of mbuzi choma should be available for you, a lot of ugali, you name it, everything will be ready, and we are ready to hear your stories, we are ready to hear each and everyone's stories, and we are hoping that day the weather will not be as cold as it is today, but it will be a bit warm. So from us at GMC, we are excited and we are very much hopeful to see each and every one of us. God bless you as we continue getting mentored. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Donut. We can see the grounds for graduation is ready. And definitely, I know that there's a criteria. I want Nagilai to tell us the criteria because not everyone will graduate. There are some people who have got supplementaries and they will join cohort 3 for them to graduate. So Nagilai, you can tell us the process.
Hello, hello, good morning. And thank you, our mentor this morning. And my apologies, today I had a challenge with my Google Chrome, but I've worked it out. So thank you. Thank you guys for joining this early. And for us to graduate, as I think I've said it before, but let me make it clear now. We need you need to have being part of this team for 70% of the lessons. So if you have attained 69, iyo ni soup, tulikuwa tunaitanga soup. So iyo ni supplementary. So, yes, that is my teacher actually. I am also a product of Mr. Joe. He also taught me. Yeah, so as he says, yeah, once you get your 69, just know that you are not part of the people who will graduate. The other thing is that the people who will graduate are the people that we will communicate to. That is, by tomorrow, you will get that communication. And we will now have a team to organize this for the next 1 week. Then thereafter, we will have our graduation. So the people who will graduate, you'll get full communication in terms of when, date, and even how we will do it. As you've heard, the Mbuzi is ready. And as Donald has said, they are ready to host us at GMC. So thank you. For those who may not have attained the pass mark or the mark to be there for us, with us for the graduation, you have another chance to attend the next cohort, that is cohort 3, and the rules do not change. If they change, they change for the better. So just know it's 70% attendance of the Zoom classes. Thank you. God bless you. Welcome, our mentor.
Wow, thank you. Thank you, Nagilai, the Vice Chancellor, for this George Washiluk School of Mentorship. They say that nothing's come for free. Yeah, somebody wrote to me, Kasema George Bwana. Me, I had an international job that was new, so I attended 30%. Kama bia pole sana, try cohort 3. Wow, so karibuni sana. So let's go to today's discussions. That is very, very interesting discussions. We are talking about innovation, partnership, and giving back as a component of rapid growth. And I picked this from the former CEO, the late Bob Collymore, who was asked by members of media. You know, the cameras were looking at him and people were listening to him. And that time they had made billions in terms of revenue. And he was asked, how comes your organization is making billions when the competitor has made equivalent loss of the same billions? And the late CEO smiled and said, it's easy. If you want to really grow rapidly and quickly and fast, three things that must happen. Number one is innovation. And then he paused a little bit, innovation. And then he smiled, looked at the cameras and said, number two, partnerships. And then as if you had completed, the last one he said, giving back. And that was profound. That was great. I remember that time I met my the Optiven leadership, and I told them, hey, for Optiven to grow, we must adopt and adapt these three things: innovation, partnership, and giving back. And I can tell you, we have tried this strategy. It has worked. I think especially the things of innovation, doing things differently, doing things anew, be it a process, be it a product, be it a service, be it a customer service, the way you handle your customers, that customers come and tell them, thank you for coming, thank you for visiting. It has really, really transformed our organization. Talk about partnership, you know. OptiVen, we had partnership with different banks. I remember one time we did a partnership with a certain bank to access their customers to buy a property. And within 3 months, we had sold a property worth about 40 acres. It was done. It was completely done. Partnerships. And of course, there are some rules and regulations of partnerships. Of course, you have done bad partnerships. Some have been ugly. So you must be very careful. You check whether you can be able to bond with a person you are partnering with. It's very, very important. And definitely giving back. You know, giving back is basically lifting other people that are less fortunate. That one, this one works magic. Look at Rockefeller Foundation. You know, this guy was a church deacon many years ago. He was once the richest man in the world. The guy died, but he is not dead. He is alive. Even here in Kenya, you know, I'm told his wealth now is bigger than the way he was when he was alive. Why? The issue of giving back, it works. It can work for you. It has worked for OptiVen. So I know most of you, like Mary Lou, you are in business. I know you are doing a lot of green manenos, you know, going green, using bicycles to ride to work, to reduce carbon. That is part of giving back. You are careful about climate change. And that is a call for all of us. You know, it's part of giving back. Taking care of the planet. Taking care of the people that are less fortunate. And giving back has worked for us. It can work for you. It is a component of growth. I remember one time, if you want to create followers, if you want to create people who believe in your brand, start this aspect of giving back. You know, go to those girls, give sanitary wear, go to schools. I know most of you, you are doing mentorship in schools. That is part of giving back. And your business will be sorted. But even before we talk about innovation, partnership, and giving back as a component of growth, we can ask ourselves as a people, as managers, as business owners, as career people, as entrepreneurs, what are some of the components of rapid business growth? How come some businesses grow so easily, others struggle? What are some of these components of business growth? And how come some businesses, they die before their 5 years? In fact, they say in the US, 50% of the businesses die before their 5 years. Here in Kenya, it's worse off. A lot of businesses die. In fact, they say for the last 5 years, we have lost 2.2 million businesses. Yeah, and they are no longer in operation. Why? And then they say only a third of businesses that survive up to the 10th year. So if your business is now 10 years, you should be happy. But what are some of these components? And we can be able to discuss five or six of these components. And of course, innovation partnership is one of them. One of them is that for you, you have to identify what sets you apart from your competition. Yeah, Wakaro, what sets you apart from competition? Remember, in Kenya today, there are 7.3 million formal and informal businesses. What sets you apart? Donut, you are GMC. What sets GMC apart from others? I know the other day, nimeona mulima hapo kubwa. I don't know the significance. Utatuambia when you are graduating, you know? What sets you apart? Professor Nyoto, what sets you apart from your training, from other trainers? What is it? Can you identify that thing? Is it customer service? You know, is it culture? Is it service? Is it a product? I remember, like for us at OptiVen, before COVID, we had a very interesting aspect of treating our customers. You know, when you come to the reception, we had the sweets. You know, it was Eclair sweets. So you come to OptiVen, you just pick. And then we had options for people. Do you take coffee? Do you take tea? Do you take water? Do you take soda? And that thing was a game changer. Can you imagine? People are even coming to say hi to us. At Hawanunui, they're not coming to buy. They just want to come to say hi. But when they come to say hi, we ask them, by the way, do you have a referral? And everybody has got a referral. And that was a game changer. I remember one time, KIM gave us the best company in customer service. So that was what was identifying Optiven from competition. Number two, what is it? What component can determine your business rapid growth? Number two, by the way, before I go to number two, even those in career, by the way you handle people, your colleagues, can also distinguish you from any other manager, can distinguish you from any other employee. The way you handle people, the way you behave. Wanasema, when so-and-so is not here, when Christopher Mugambi is not here, I think there is a gap, you know? Because the way you handle people, in the morning you say hi to them. You know, they ask, hey, where is Eric Igambi? Leo akowapi? Akowapi leo? You know, people are asking because the way you handle people, that is what we are talking about. Number two, know who is your ideal customer. Yeah. Eh? Dennis Kiunga. Dennis, you are there. Who is your ideal customer? Remember, business is not like a political rally. You know, political rally, they expect everyone. They expect the hustlers. They expect the dynasty. They expect the middle of dynasty and hustlers, everyone. But for business, it's different. Who is your ideal customer? Yeah. Ni nani? Are they the youth? Eh? Middle-aged? The old? Who are they? Hmm? Understand. Once you understand your ideal customer, you understand what they need. They need. What do they need? This customer. Like now my sister is selling insurance. Whom are you targeting? And what do these people know? What do these people want? Wanataka nini? And once you do that, I can tell you, you'll be able to identify what to offer to them. You become more competitive, the growth will be evident, and definitely when you know your customer, what happens? You know where to advertise. You know whom to target. You know where to market. And you can be able to come up with a brand message. Can you imagine people selling Mercedes-Benz? Eh? With no offense, people selling Mercedes-Benz, and you find them with a banner somewhere in the informal settlement. Wanasema tunauza Mercedes-Benz. Unaona hawa watu kishwa imeruka. They know where to pitch. They go to Karen Hub. They pitch there. They go to Waterfront. In fact, the other day I went to the hub. Nikakuta guys selling a Ford, you know, new ones. And they are packed there because they know their target market. Let me ask you. I know most of you are doing business. Wairimo Moshai. You know, I can see you are doing good business. Wairimo Moshai. Your customers, unajua wanataka nini? Do you know where to get them? When you do Google ads, do you say, my ads must be seen from the age 30 to 50? Wairimo Moshai. That's the strategy you are talking about. You know? Know who is your ideal. The word is ideal customer. Very, very important. Number three, as a component of rapid growth. Number three, understand your KPIs. Yeah. Key performance indicators. Why? If you don't understand your key performance indicators, you'll be running this city. I hear people have baptized our city. Inaitwa Kanairo, you know? I don't know what Kanairo means, but I was trying to Google it. They say a harsh place. Hey, my friend. So if you don't understand your KPIs, you'll be chasing your customers, your business all over. How do you know that you are growing? How do you know? Utajuaje? Maybe you can type for me on the chat line. How do you know that... Wairimu Mushai, how do you know that your business is growing? Eh? Paul Mutugi, how do you know? Ipa Wangui, utajuaji, you are on the right track. Eh? Joseph, how do you know that your consultancy is on the move? Maybe you can type for me some KPIs that you check. What do you check that you are growing? Because KPIs help you to keep track. Uh-huh. Someone has segmented the customer. This is Wairimu Mushai. I like that. Based on geographical areas. Yeah. Oh, yes. Segment your customers based on their geographical areas. I really like that. Because now you know, if you're advertising, you say this advert can only be seen by the people from Kitengela. Mereduo increase sales volume. Yeah, that's a KPI. Mereduo says when she sees increase in sales volume, definitely that's a KPI, key performance indicators that your business is growing. Keep typing. Let me see more. How do you, let me see more. Martin, when you start getting high-end client, I like that. Wow. Wow. Thank you, Martin. High-end client. Wakianza kukuja, ujue something is coming. Bane says profit increase. Yeah. Pesa ikiongezeka. Unaona end of the year. The profit is higher. The bottom line is better. That's a good KPI. David Jologe, positive comments from customers. Yes, I agree. Yeah, that's brand building. Dennis Kiunga, growth in clients database. I totally agree with Dennis Kiunga. Yes, growth in a clients database. That's a good KPI that you are doing something. Brandsmew says, happy clients. Yeah, Brandsmew, when you do for them websites, Brian, they are happy. They tell you, you have done a good job. Yeah, that's a KPI, it's an indicator. Alex Bogua, referrals. Yeah, I totally agree. Referrals. Everyone going. So they are going mepita kidogo. Vincent Barnes again. Customer retention. Yeah, customer retention. Yeah, customer retention. It works magic. Customer retention. Very, very important. Lucy, when I get a referral client, that is true. Lucy Jogona. People are referring business to you. It means that you are performing. Understand your KPIs. You need to track those KPIs. You need to measure them. You need to optimize on those KPIs to ensure that work is happening. Okay. Number four, have a firm grasp of your business financials. Yeah. They say you must understand figures. You must understand numbers. You have to understand the numbers. What do the numbers say? Yeah, the ratios, the gearing ratios. What do these numbers say? You must understand numbers. That's why we have a course called Finance for Non-Finance Entrepreneurs. You need to understand accounting kidogo, little accounting, so that you are able to grasp the numbers. They say if you don't know your numbers, your business growth could be cut short unexpectedly. Yeah. Lazima ujue numbers. You have to know, do I invest in this capital investment or do I retain this money for my cash flows? They say cash flow is the bloodstream for any business. I have seen my friends, you know, when they get money, what they do first is to buy a capital investment that doesn't give them any money. You know, you buy an investment that doesn't generate money for you. Maybe you are... Your cash flow is not so good, but you go ahead, buy a Prado. You know, buy a Prado. Yet, you could have bought a Premio that can help you move from point A to point B. And there's something that I learned from my Asian friends. You may find a very wealthy Asian, but they're just driving a simple car. Just a simple car. Because the time you put that 4 million, 3 million, 5 million, and it is not generating money. In any way, you are putting fuel. So you start affecting your cash flows. And most of our businesses actually fail because of cash flows. Hauna pesa. You know, suppliers are demanding, you have no money. KRA is looking for money, you have no money. Why? Because you tied up your money. That's why you find that some of these big financial institutions, they have a slogan, they are saying, no brick and mortar. Yeah, they are no longer buying offices. They are leasing. They are leasing offices. They know what they are saying. So understand your financials. Number five, invest in the right talent. Hey, this is it's a good component of rapid growth. Invest in the right talent. Are you there? Can you afford people who can help you build your business? Yeah. Invest in the right talent. If you're hiring an accountant, get somebody who have got a good experience, can do the books, and can make your work easy. They say a company is only good as the team behind it. Yeah. The company is as good as a team behind it. Let me now challenge all these business people, managers, and entrepreneurs. All the time, make yourself better. Eh? Babla, all the time, make yourself better. Soma kidogo. You know, yesterday I was doing a forward for a friend of mine who has done a book. I think the book is called Fading Forward. And I read his story. You know, this guy actually got a C in Form 4. But he said, I must keep educating myself. Right now he's doing a PhD. And I want to challenge all of us. We can be able to educate ourselves so that even as you do your business, the wisdom, the knowledge that you have can take you to the next level. And by the way, education has no age. Regardless of your current situation, you can go back and keep adding that knowledge. And that way, you develop your own talent, even as you develop the talents of your people. Very, very important. The last one is what we are discussing today, innovation, partnership, and giving back. And maybe you can tell me how you think or whether you practice this a component of growth, innovation, partnership, and giving back. And you can type for me on the chat line to see whether you practice it, has it worked for you, and you'll be able to see what is happening. But before you do that, how can you tell that your business is growing? Regardless of these components, how can you tell? You have already told me, I like the chat line, people are typing. Some people have said, health cash flows, yeah. Healthy cash flows. Yeah, ni pesa inaingia, unaiona. You are able to pay your debts, you are able to pay your liabilities, very, very important. Number two, market penetration. I think one of the mentees talked about geographical way of segmenting customers. Market penetration, bigger market share. You know, there is no business that doesn't have competition. The other day, I had a meeting yesterday with a guy who runs a very good media in the diaspora. In fact, it's one of the most popular media. But I was asking him, how are you coping with so many people having their own radios? Muda nafugua tu Facebook. Anaita Dennis Kiunga radio station. Facebook tu. Muda nafugua YouTube. Anaita Paul Mutugi TV. And this TV has got only 300 followers. So I was asking the guy, how are you coping with this competition? And then the guy told me, man, it has not been easy. But we have a bigger market share. Why? We started early. We give value. We give back. We partner. That's why we are here, to partner with Optivent. So we have a bigger market share. And those are some of the things that can tell you that you are on the right track. Number three, diversification. So once you have this excess money, you say, wait a minute, I can now go to the next level of diversifying my offering. So if you're doing fashion, for example, maybe you'll be doing clothes fashion only, you can say, now I'm going to another line of shoes or bags. So once you find you have excess money to diversify, you can tell the business is growing. Fantastic. Let me share with you some things that I've done, you know, some key ingredients of growth. And this one can work for you. It has worked for Optivin. It has worked for me. Some key ingredients of growth. Very interesting. Income a recipe for growth. And you can try it. I will share with you only four. Some are not very good to you. They will hurt you, but they are good. One of them is feedback. Yes, feedback. Paul, when you get angry feedback, don't, Paul Kibogo, don't spend sleepless nights. Think about that feedback and how you can improve. Like for us who are in real estate, we get all kind of very, very ugly feedback. You know, you told somebody, I'm selling this property on installments, but we charge interest. Let me tell you, the time you load interest, mtu nakuuliza, wewe ni bank, are you a bank? You are loading interest. I'll pay the original price. But out of that, you learn something that next time, communicate. Let the customer understand. And some of us, we are very, very sensitive to feedback. Eva Wangui, some of us, we are very sensitive to feedback. In fact, we overreact. And I want to encourage you, the time you get very, very negative feedback, don't respond immediately. Have a post. Post kidogo. Come at the Red Bob Colimo. You post. In fact, go and take tea. Yeah. Go take some tea. Or porridge. then come back and respond, because we grow through feedback. That's why we say that if you have friends that only tell you, yes, yes, professor, eh? Yes, yes, Joseph, yes, yes, that's dangerous. Those are dangerous friends. You need people to tell you when things are not okay. You need people to challenge you when things are not okay. Even your own staff, by the way, Alex Bogwa, even your own staff, you need to identify people who say, hey, wait a minute, I think this one cannot work, or this one can work. Feedback. Number two, mistakes. Yeah, mistakes. They say every time you make a mistake, you're a lesson. And don't blame yourself. When mistakes happen, you lose money. No, don't blame yourself. Don't die of stress, because businesses, they are made up of trying ideas. And somebody said, any idea that is not tried is an opportunity lost. So keep trying, Kevin. Kevin Wakonyo, keep trying. You will make those mistakes. And out of those mistakes, you will be able to learn something. Mologo Samuel, make those mistakes, because out of those, you implement an idea that will be a game changer for the planet. Number three, challenges. Yeah, yeah. Hakuna biashara haina challenges. Usidaganywe na mutu. Even the biggest businesses like Microsoft. I'm sure you know the challenges happening in Microsoft. You are all aware. They could not be financial challenges, but social challenges, you know? And that's why for you guys as leaders, the way you behave in the office, the way you behave towards your employees, you must be very careful. You know what is happening in some of these organizations. So challenges will come, but when these challenges come, some could be financial. Yeah, some could be a supplier who sues you, you know? Some could be your customers. You made a mistake, umepelekwa kotini, you know? You know, when I was young in business, I really feared courts. Only to discover, one time I went to a courtroom and I saw some of the people we really respect, big companies. You know, as we had one case in court, they had 18 mentions in the same court. I said, wait a minute. I think business and court issues, they are inseparable, because challenges will come. But when those challenges come, my friend, that's the time to pick. That's the time to learn. That's the time to say, how can we do things differently? You know, because there is no business, no career. Paul Mukoma, I'm happy to see you here. You know? Paul Mukoma is my good friend. You know, challenges will come, and then keep picking those challenges and learning from them. Then lastly, Duncan Irongo, lastly, you have to put effort. Yeah, can you imagine having here this follow-up at 7? Even the effort, I am sure Paul Mukoma woke up at 4. Lillian, you woke up early. Some are in diaspora, Elizabeth. You require effort. You have to make things move. Nothing comes easy. You know, nothing comes easy. Sophie is a candidate, is a student in the University of Nairobi. Nothing comes easy. You have to really, really put a lot of effort. The other day I was checking these guys of Safari Learning. Hey, nikasema kweli hii ni maneno mengine. Yani, you see the guy is driving so fast. If something happens, you know, you are almost kissing death. And you saw what happened to some of them. Some lost their backbone. I can see Paul Mukoma woke up at 3 a.m. Well done. Hey, effort, man. Paul Mukoma, I value you. 3 a.m., the guy was awake. And now he's here. No wonder you are succeeding. Effort is a must. Wow, interesting. The last part of my presentation is benefits of business growth. Benefits of business growth. Benefits. Benefits. Once your business grows, what happens? Lose a minor, you become an influencer in the marketplace. When you speak, people want to listen. Yeah, that's a good benefit. You become an influencer. You become an advisor because you have done it. You can imagine if I tell you today that the next session, we are having Dr. James Mwangi. Hey, utaona hii platform imefula. Yani, imekua, imeexceed. Why? Because Dr. James Mwangi has done business, has been very successful, He is an influencer. And that's what happens when your business grows. Number two, you reduce external risks. Yeah, once your business grows, you forget about many risks, small things. Because when you grow, you have diversified. There are many avenues of revenue. And number three, you put more money back to business. When business grows, I urge all of you, put that money back to the business so that our businesses are able to go across the border. I always challenge people that most of Kenya businesses, they are within the Kenyan borders. Yet, we are not able to grow our businesses to go beyond the border. And that's for us at Optiven. We are saying we are looking at being in 20 African countries by the year 2041. It is possible, it's doable. Eh? Isabel Degwa, it is possible. You can grow beyond your borders. You can grow beyond your county. Why? Because opportunities are there. And once you grow, you put that money back to the organization and then you keep growing. The last one, when business grow, you have a voice. Yeah, when business grow, and cover, you have a voice. Yeah, you can be an opinion leader. That's why I ask those of you who are not members of Kenya Private Sector Alliance, you need to join, because that's where people engage government. That's where your voice can be heard. That's where, Edward Bogo, that's where the bills are shared before going to parliament. And you can only do that if your business is growing. And when I look at all of you, we have potential, we have capacity to grow our businesses, to grow our careers to the next level. Because if others are doing it, why not us? We can do it. And the bonus point, when business grows, you increase your resources. Yeah, you increase your resources. Resources in terms of employees, resources in terms of financial, resources in terms of all what it takes to grow a business. You can do it, it is possible. If others are doing it, you can also do it. There is no miracle in growing business. There are some principles that we are learning here that we can be able to grow. Those who are in career, you can also grow your career. Make yourself too relevant that an employer cannot do without you, you know. Too relevant that when you're not there, your boss will know for sure, so and so. Livingstone is not here because you are very, very relevant. As we conclude, let's talk about innovation, partnership, and giving back. This is the time I want you to tell me, have you ever participated in any of this component? How are you doing your innovation? How are you generating new ideas, new ways of doing things? How are you doing the partnership? Are you giving back? You just tell me what your organization is doing. Right now, we are talking about taking care of our planet Earth. For us at Optiven, we are saying we must go green. And we don't go green alone. We are encouraging other people. Right now, we have a huge event coming up on 11th of December at Move and Peak, whereby we are awarding 25 business people, SMEs, who are taking care of the planet Earth. As long as you are implementing any of sustainable development goals, you can nominate yourself. And you have a link, www.optivengogreen.com. You nominate yourself, maybe you're planting trees. Tell us, go to that Go Green Optiven Facebook, post those photos. We have judges that are checking what people are doing. By the end of the year, we shall be able to give you a huge publicity. We shall give you an award to tell you that, yes, you are doing something of giving back to the planet. Why? If you look at the planet today, it is under attack. People are using resources so quickly, and we are so many. We are now 7.9 billion, and we are saying you can be able to do a small part. So just type on the chat line, tell me what you are doing on this component, innovation, partnership, and giving back. Tell me what you are doing, and I'll read your comment. Please tell me what you're doing. Let's see whether we are walking the talk. Let me place my camera properly so that I read the comments nicely. So tell me, what are you doing? Let me see. Yeah, I can now read it very nicely. Mm-hmm. Yeah, tell me. And thank you. Thank you. Innocent says, on feedback and mistake, I have personally gone to fix or collect doors which the client feel were not done as per the specifications. Why? I have to give value for money. Hey, I like that. Thank you so much, Innocent. And you said, yes, personally, umetengeneza milango. Then you personally go and pick those doors. I think I really like that. I like that. That's very good. Raymond Budi. Oh, Raymond Budi. Oh, you're on the platform. Welcome, Raymond Budi. Raymond says, innovation. I am installing green solar-powered CCTV system. Hey, Raymond, you need to nominate yourself on the platform, www.optivengogreen.com. Wow, I like that. You are giving back to the planet, giving back to our planet to ensure that carbon dioxide is less. Hey, guys, don't be quiet on me. Tell me what you're doing on innovation, partnership, and giving back. I want to read your comment. Brand Simu says, on long-term vision at TechFi Business, we want to mentor young ladies into tech industry as a CSR. Wow, Simu, I like that. Yeah, you want to mentor young ladies into tech industry as a CSR. Mm-hmm. Eva Wangoi says, we are going to offer extended childcare hours before, it's moving very fast. Let me read it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Wow, it's moving fast. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we are going to offer extended childcare hours before and after school to enable parents to support working parents. I really like that. Eva, that's good. Giving back to the community. Wairimu Moshai says, on innovation, I keep researching. I like that. Listening to customers, I like that. And with these, I am able to come up with unique ideas on sustainable agriculture. I really love that, listening to the customers. Partnership, I am currently on a journey to start a partnership with a farm in Kisumu to help agroecology and pharmaculture as a way to bring safe food. I really love that. Hey, nominate yourself. Giving back, I am a full-time humanitarian, giving back through tree planting and giving small gardens to children, homes, and rescue something. Wow, very proud of Arimo Moshai. I can't wait to meet you on graduation. You are doing an amazing job. Wow. Christopher Mugambi, as a minister, going out voluntarily to offer prayers, wow, I like that, counseling to the needy, wow, sponsoring the needy children to go to school. Wow, this is very touching. Thank you, Christopher. Very proud of you. Beatrice, innovation, soil testing partnerships with cooperatives, giving free soil testing to selected cooperative members. I like that. Thank you, Bernice. Hey, you guys, you are good. You are making my heart happy. I am happy. Paul Kibogo, Leogenic Africa. Huh? Leogenic Africa. We ensure fertilizer safety, nourish our crops, as well as regenerating our soils. Wow. Hey, you guys, you are top. I like it. Isabel Degua, mentoring and coaching young employees for effective succession management, as I am a career person. Wow. May God bless your career. You're doing an amazing job. Giving back. Elizabeth, I am reaching out to a high school mentoring them on making good choices in their lives. You are doing an amazing job, Elizabeth. That's very encouraging. Marion Joyce, giving back, going back to my roots. I like that, to empower people on the importance of insurance. Information is power. I agree. Opening a YouTube channel. Please open that YouTube channel. Share it here. We shall follow you. Well done. Wakalo, though the company I am giving back to my church, to visiting our National Park Savo East for afternoon's game drives for free. I like that. Wow, this is a tour, man. Please put your link. We need to know your tour firm so that we also give you business. Lucy Jambi, I am educating an orphan. Wow, that's very good. As part of giving back, God opened us for you. Very, very encouraging. Nagirai, thank you for sharing the website, www.optimumgogreen. Very good. You guys, you are doing giving back to the communities, to the ground, to the planet. Please nominate yourself. Eric is there, Igambi. I am taking part in Kenya Airways Fahari Innovation Challenge. I like that, to help them rebuild customers' volumes post-COVID Wow, very encouraging. I will share how the challenge will go. I like that. Please share with the team. Ben M, on giving back, I designed a website for free for an organization dealing with child growth and mental health. I really love that, Ben. Well done. Alex Bogwa, innovation, having great customer relationship that influences and increases my customer networking in the marketplace partnerships. Partnership, giving back, has partnered with an organization that gives back monthly. I really love that. Wow. Mary Duo, packaging policy to reduce landfills. I like that. On planet Earth, green cleaning. I like that. Products that are less corrosive. Wow. I think we need to engage you. Less toxic, eco-friendly, and biodegradable cleaning products. Hey, you have touched my heart for sure. Catherine, on Quare, giving back, mentoring, and supporting girls to complete their education. Wow. My vision is to establish an institution to support the needy. I really love that. Donald Moriuki, at my workplace, we are partnering with businesses around Kitengela, especially schools, and offering them products that are unique. This is a result of uniqueness of our products as being child-friendly, while might not be available in schools and homes. Wow, I get what you're saying, Donald, well done. Paul Mutugi, innovation, what you're doing. We at Kijani Eco Solutions are automating our systems and coming with mobile app to help our customers to have the best shopping experience. Please share the link there, Mutugi. Very good, Wakaro, again, you have shared the link, very, very important. And lastly, Isabel Degwa, guidance and counseling to vulnerable youth in the informal settlements. Lastly, Jeff says, giving back, always doing or joining charity drives to help children homes and less fortunate. Thank you very much, Jeff. You need to join Optimum Foundation in our campaigns. And then there's Catherine again. Personally, I like trees. Wow, I plant at least 500 trees every year. Please, Catherine, go to Optimum. Go green up to Facebook. Please post those photos. You never know, something can come your way. James, this is the last one. Midway Hospital, offering excellent services and periodic free medical checkups. Hey, James, you are doing an amazing job. Thank you, team. Thank you, team. Our time is very well spent. And once again, I want to thank everyone. Thank you for the work you are doing. I am extremely inspired reading those comments that you are on the move to change our planet. You are on the move to change our businesses. You are on the move to change where you are working. And I wish you all the very best. I look forward to this graduation and the next session. And I am so proud of you. So God bless you and have a fantastic day. Back to Nagilai.
Wow. That was something. That was great. We really appreciate you, sir. And I can see we already have mentors here. Yes, people are already equipped. People are ready to move to the next level. And we can see what most of us are doing. And we thank God because all of us, we are here and we are products of this mentorship. And we thank God that our mentor decided to do this. Because if he had not decided to do this, you can imagine, we will not have seen some of us here today. So we will not have known some of us or some of the faces that you are seeing here. So we thank God for this far. And so far we have done, let's say 99.9 classes. So we only have, let's say 0.1 remaining. So we will meet next week for our last class, and thereafter we will do the graduation. Thank you. God bless you, and see you next week. Asante sana.
Okay. Nagilai, there's a question there. Somebody's asking if they can tag along a friend. So I'll leave that to the committee to decide so that we are able to manage the numbers. So Nagilai, I'm sure you handle that with the committee organizing the graduation. Asante sana. Now the meeting is officially adjourned. God bless you.